Yes, so dear student, I Rakesh Jain from Gyan Vihar University. Today I am going to teach you how to do the microcontroller programming. So today we will discuss about how to generate a square wave on any particular bidirectional pin of 8051 microcontroller. After the completion of this video, you will be able to understand how to use the Keil software, how to use the Proteus software, and how to design a program for how to make a program of 8051 microcontroller in assembly language program. So first of all, see this MS Paint file where I'm going to write down today object. Today object is, the first object is we have to find out, write a program to generate a square wave on any pin you can choose. Let P0.3 we choose. So write a program to generate a square wave on P0.3. Okay, it is not mentioned that what kind of delay you should use, 10 millisecond, 5 millisecond, 3 millisecond for on period, for off period, nothing is given. So we can use any delay for the same. So first of all, as we know that in 8051 microcontroller there are four ports: port 0, port 1, port 2 and port 3, where each port consists 8 pins. From port 0 consists P0.0 to P0.7, port 1 consists P1.0 to P1.7, port 2 consists P2.0 to P2.7, and port 3 consists P3.0 to P3.7. So actually there are four bidirectional ports, and in all ports we can provide the input or we can take the output from those pins of 8051 microcontroller. So here it is clearly mentioned that we have to generate a square wave on P0.3. It means we have to use the third number, P0.3 pin of 8051 microcontroller, so that it will generate a square wave there. To see the square wave on software, we can connect a CRO oscilloscope there, so it will generate a square wave. First of all, how to make a program. So because we know that in a square wave consists of one and zero shape like this one, a square wave can be easily drawn by this. Let's suppose this is one, then zero, then one, then zero, then one, then zero. And when we will just make this wave, this will be a square wave. It will be a shape of a square wave. Yes. So it means we have to continuously toggle in between the one value and zero value continuously. One value and zero value continuously, we have to toggle in between one and zero. And after reaching one, there should be some time wasting, some delay should be there, so that this kind of shape will be generated. At zero, there should be some delay, so that long time will be created, wasted there, so that a delay will be there, so that this kind of shape will be achieved. So to do the, and which one is this pin? This pin is P0.0, 0.3, where I want this square wave. To find out this kind of waveform, first of all, we should put that particular pin value equal to high, that is one there. Okay, after putting one there, we have to provide some delay, and because the delay is not mentioned here, we can use any delay to add that pin. Okay, after that, achieving that delay, it should be complement, that the value of one will be complement into zero, and again the same, again one, again zero, and this process will be. Set B and any pin name here, P0.3 we write down. It means we put one at the P0.3. Set B means P0.3 value is equal to one. Okay, then we have to waste some time there. We have to provide some delay there. So delay is as a subroutine, we have to call that delay. So A call, and we write down the name of that subroutine as delay. We can write down any name. Even you can write down your name Amit. So you can write down A call Amit. If I want to use my name there, so I can use there A call Rakesh. Any name for the delay, you can mention in 8051 microcontroller. So here I use the standard name delay as a delay. So A call delay means after putting P0.3 equal to 1, it will A call delay means absolute call the delay. It will, the program will suddenly jump at the delay location. So where is the delay location? Let's suppose delay is this location. What I want here, I just want to provide some delay, but it is not mentioned in the program that what delay you want to provide, what delay you want to provide. That's why you can choose any number into a register and just decrement that register till it will be zero, till it will be zero. So in between that time of decrement and reaching the zero from any value, whatever you have already been uploaded in that register, there is some time wasting. That is, it will provide you the delay. Okay. So let's suppose I use a register R1 and put any value. For the value, I just put a value 255. Okay. Sorry. Yes, I just put a value 255 there. Okay, so move R1 comma has 255. It means R1 is equal to 255. Then I write down an instruction, decrement and jump node 0, R1 comma any location. Let the location name is VBV. And where is this VBV? VBV is at the same place of this instruction. Now, what is the meaning of this instruction? Decrement and jump node 0. R1 comma VBV means first delay. What is at the location delay? Move R1 comma 255. It means R1 is equal to 255. It means R1 is equal to 255. Okay. So R1 is 255. So now what I write down? I write down decrement and jump node 0 R1 comma VBV. It means decrement the register R1 by 1 and till that time it will not equal to 0, jump at this location. The instruction is like this one, decrement and jump node 0 to any register. It will maybe R1, R2, R3, B register, R7 register, any register. And here we have to write down the location. This is the instruction. So decrement the register by 1 each time, decrement the register value by 1. So minus 1 I show you, by minus 1. Okay, it means the register value is will be decremented by 1 continuously. At each time it will be decremented by 1, then it decremented by 1, then it will decremented by 1. So continuously it will be decremented by 1, and till the time it will not equal to 0, it will jump at this location, whatever you write down. So to use that instruction, I write down in the program as decrement and jump node 0 R1. So R1 is what? 255. Now it is decremented by 1. So it is now 254. Is it 0? No, it is not 0. If it is not 0, jump at VBV. Where is the VBV? VBV is at the same place of decrement jump down. Now again jump at VBV, again to decrement and jump node 0 R1. So again, R1 will be decremented by 1. So it was 253, now it will be 253. Sorry, 254, now it will be 253. Is it 0? No, it is not 0. It is not 0, so again jump at VBV. So continuously, it will decremented by 1, 1, 1, 1. Continuously, it will be decremented by 1. And till the time, it will be continuously decremented, decremented, and again jump at the same location. At last, it will be 1. After that, again decremented R1 by 1. Now it will be 0. Because it is 0, now we don't want that it will be jump at VBV location. It will be go in the next step. And what is the next step? The next step I write down as RAT. RAT means again jump into the main location. Again jump into the main location. Or we can say in a very simple language, again jump at the location, the next location from which we jump from. Jump at the new location or next location from where we have already been jumped from. Jahan se hum, okay, so A call delay, this is the subroutine manner. This is the subroutine manner in case of microcontroller. Like A call and RAT. A call is just jump from main program into the subroutine. and again jump from subroutine into the main program, we have to write down the instruction RET, return to the main program. So after this, first of all, set BP 0.3, it means there is one. Then there is some delay, and delay is what? Time wasting. R1 is equal to 255, and till it will be zero, it will remain in this loop. So till that time, it will be done in a millisecond. So it is very fast. But till that millisecond time, it will be reached at one. Okay. Now I write down rate. So again, jump into the main location. Again, jump into the main location. And what I want here? Now I want complement of one, so that zero will be reached. So I write down complement P0.3. Complement P0.3 means whatever the value previously of 0.3, it will now complicate that value, complicate. Okay, so it was one, now it will be zero. Now what I want again? I want some delay at zero, so that a square wave will be created. So I again want a delay, that's why I write down again a call delay. After this complement, I again write down a call delay. So what will happen? Again, the main program jump into the sub program. Subroutine. So again, R1 is equal to 255. There is some time wasting. There is some delay till the R1 decrement value will not be equal to zero, one by one. 255, then 254, then 253, then 252, 2, then 9, then 7, then 6, and then 0. Okay. Till that time, it will be at zero position only. Till the time it will reach again from the delay, it will be zero. Okay. Now, after completing this, again jump into the main program. In the next step, from where it jumped from. So it jumped from here. Now, what I want? I want this continuous. One, then some delay, then zero, then some delay, again one, then some delay. So I again want to jump. So to jump at any particular location, there is a instruction S jump. And let's suppose the location is RRR. You can write down any location name in microprocessor. So S jump RRR. And where is this RRR? This RRR is the main position, the uppermost position. Now this is a complete program. This is a complete program of generating a square wave at any pin P0.3. So first of all, I just save this file. Then we will do this on PLAN Proteus software. So this is a program. First of all, we should know that how to make a program of 8051 microcontroller. So this is a very simple way to generate a square wave. We should need some steps, and these are the particular steps by which we can do the programming. So if you understand, and if you don't have any query, then type in message box OK. So I will proceed. Type in message box OK if you understand the programming, how to do the programming. Then we will start with KeyLand Proteus software, how to run the program and how to create the hex file. Type in message box OK if you understand, Amit Kumar. Okay, very good. Now we should use, in case of microcontroller, a Keel software to convert this assembly language program. This is an assembly language program, but we know that microcontroller or microprocessor, these are those devices which actually run from the binary value 10, because we have to do the programming on a computer system via the Keel software. So it will understand the hex code value that is generated in format of hexadecimals. So to convert this assembly language into the particular required format of hex file, can be generated with the help of Keel software. Okay, so how to use the Keel software? First of all, you should create, I just remove this file, you just take a snapshot here, you just take a snapshot. So I will, when I will type the program on Keel software, you will check that the programming is same. Okay, now I am removing this MS Paint and open the folder where we will start the program. So now I just stop this presentation, take the snapshot. Okay, so I just stop this presentation. Now see. Yeah. So first of all, you are able to see now. The desktop is in front of you. Okay. So when we download the Keel software in our computer system or in laptop, a icon automatically created in the desktop, that is of Keel software icon. So here, first of all, I just click the Keel software icon double times. So automatically a window will be open, that is of Keel software. Now I am showing you the same window. This is your Keel software window. Yes, this is our Keel software window. Now there are certain steps by which we can do the programming. First of all, before starting this, first of all, just create a folder on the desktop. Before starting the program, first of all, create the software on desktop. So to create the software, I just show you the desktop window again. Now this is my desktop, which is in front of you. Now I am creating a window. Now, first of all, I am creating a folder. Right click, then new, and then create a folder. And here I write down the folder name is Square View. Okay, done. Then open the Keel software. So I have already been open the Keel software. So I am showing you now the Keel software window. This one is the window of Keel software. Okay. So the first step is to create a folder, first of all, because there are lots of file, hex file, nap file. There are so many files which have already been created after completing this Keel software work. So the desktop will not be full from those files. That's why we create, first of all, the folder. Now, what is the next step? See the all the steps. Now go to the project, then new, and then micro version project. Micro version project. Then click on that. So when you go on project, then new micro version project. Okay, once again I am showing you. When you go on project, then new micro version project. Once again, I'm showing you. When you go on project and new micro version project, then automatically a window will be open. That is actually asking you that where you want to build your programming. So at the desktop, go to the same location. So what is your location? The location is Square View. You created already the folder whose name is Square View. Now open that folder and type any name to save that file. So let the name is Practical One. Practical. I just write down the name as Practical. Okay, then Practical, or you can see, yes, any name you can give, then save. When you will save that file, then automatically a window will be open that show you that which target device you want to choose. So you have to use the device as of Atmel Corporations, that is Atmel. So I just click on Atmel, then go to the 8089C51, then go on 8089C51. Okay, and then click OK. Then no. Okay. Then just create a new file here. New file here. So when you click on the new file, or you can also go on file and then new file. Okay. So a window will be open, a clear window will be open where you have to type your program. So I just shown you the program of that. Okay. So if you have that program, which I just typed few minutes ago on MS Paint file of Square View, you have that image, so you can easily see on this, compare that one with this. So first step was sed bp 0.3. I just type the same programming here, which I done already. So sed bp 0.3, then a call delay, then complement p 0.3, then again a call delay, then delay look sjump to RRR, and where was the RRR? I just see the MS Paint file. You can compare that one. SM to RRR. Then delay was there, and this subroutine tells that use any value in a register R1 so that a delay will be created, because no specified delay is given. That's why we use any value 255. Then DVB is the location, decrement and jump not 0 the R1 value by 1 until it will not be 0. Jump at DVB. Then red, and at last we have to type the end after the completion of the program. So you see that I typed the same program which I have already been shown you on that MS Paint file. Once again, I am showing you that MS Paint file so you understand that of which program I am talking about. So I am talking about the same program. Okay, now you are able to see. Only remember one thing, that at last of any program there should be always the instruction end is always there. End is always there. So don't be confused. At any program of microcontroller, the last instruction is end instruction, END, the program end instruction. Okay. So the same program I typed there. I typed there. Once again, I'm showing you the same window of the keel software. Okay. So this was the your file. Your program which we understand previously about the square wave generation. Then you have to click on that target plus, then you will see automatically a source group is written there. Then right click on over there, then right click over there, then automatically when you will write down right click there, make a right click there, then automatically there is an option add file to group source. It is easily I am able to see here, but in recording in that virtual laboratory you are not able to see that one. But when I click on add file to group source, automatically a window will be open, and I hope you are able to see that window. Okay, I again show you that when I right click there, there is a folder name add file to group source. So automatically a folder is in front of you. Write down the name of that program. First of all, file of type C source file is written. Just click there, ASM source file. Okay, now open the a file is not, we have not shown, it is not able to show that assembly language file here because we did not save that file. So first of all, after writing down the program, click on file, then click on save as, then click on save as. So you have to write down the same name in the same folder. The folder was square wave, which is in front of you. The name of the programming is practical. So write down the same name but with extension ASM, because this is assembly language program. So I just write down the same name of the file, practical but with dot ASM extension there, then save this file. Okay, now you have to click on source group. Right click on source group, you will see a option add file to group source, which you are not able to see in this recording, but it is shown when you will work on the keel software. Okay, I am able to see this one. So click on add file to group source, then suddenly a folder will be open that tell you that where is the file. Because this is a assembly language ASM file, so click on ASM source file, then suddenly you will see the practical.asm which you have just saved few minutes ago. Then add, click on add. So when you will click on add, it will automatically add to your source group file. So now you are able to see that practical.asm is here. Okay, after that you have to go on flash. So there is an option configure flash tool. In flash there is an option configure flash tool, which are you are not able to see on this recording, but remember my words, when you click on flash, automatically configure flash tool will be open. Okay, so click on output. Now click on output and click on create hex file. Create hex file. Okay, then okay. Okay, now if the program is correct and there will be no error, automatically it will be run. So before running that one, take a snapshot and send me on WhatsApp. Take a snapshot and send me on WhatsApp right now. Now after this, you have to click on the middle terminal, that is bold target. So when you will click on that bold target, it will check the program, and if there is any error, it show you that there is an error. So click on that error. So in the third line, there is an error. Yes, there is an error. I write down complement P.3, but it is P0.3, na? So that's why it is an error. So now you can save this file and then boot the target. Now you will see there is zero error and zero warning here. So now automatically your hex file is created in the same folder which you named as square view. Now check the folder. Now close this one because your work is done, have already been done. Now open the folder because I created the folder on the desktop. So I open the desktop first of all. So now desktop is in front of you. Now desktop is in front of you. Yes. Yes. Now click on square view folder. So this is the square view folder. Now double click on that square view folder. There. Now see. Yes, see the third one, practical, at the right hand side it is write down that hex file. So it is that hex file which we when upload in a microcontroller IC, then it will run on the same basis as it was programmed. So this is the hex file. This is the work of Keel software to convert any assembly language program into a hex file. So with the help of this, we can easily convert the assembly language program into the corresponding hex file. So now see the next one. And wait for a while, I just take a snapshot. Now, after creating this hex file, we have to run the Proteus software and we will see how the result will come from. So now I stop this presentation and open the Proteus software from the desktop. Okay. Yes. At the desktop, now you are able to see this desktop. Yes. So at this desktop, I already downloaded a software named Proteus. So I first of all just click on that software Proteus. Where is the Proteus? Here. See Proteus 7 Professions. So I just double click on there. Then go into the bin. Go into bin. I will go into the bin. Sorry. Again, go into the bin. Now, after clicking the Proteus software, now my work of Keel software is completed, that the assembly language program convert into a hex file. Now I open the Proteus software and run the program. I just put that hex file, upload that hex file or burn the IC by that hex file and we will see the result. So just click on Proteus software, which is available at the desktop. Now once again, I am showing you at the desktop. Proteus software is available, Proteus 7 Professional. I just double click over there, then go to bin, then go to ISIS. See, there is an icon of ISIS. Now double click that icon. So your Proteus software will be open. So now I just to show you that after opening the Proteus software, how it will be looks like. So when you will click on that Proteus software, a window will be open. That is this window. This window will be open in front of you with a message in front of you that do you want to view these files? So no, just click on no. No. Okay. Then okay, when I mean okay, now you have to go to P, then go to microprocessor IC, because in this software all the microprocessor and microcontroller ICs are available in the folder of microprocessor IC. So go to microprocessor IC, and which one is the IC? It is 80C51, that is CMOS IC 8051 microcontroller. So just click on 80C51 and click on OK. When you click on OK, again your Proteus software will be open. So just click at any place. Okay. So I just click at this place. To increase the size, you can click on P. So you will be able to see this. Okay, no problem. Okay, so this is your microcontroller IC. Okay. Now what I want to burn the same program which we done, which I have already been done in the previously, which I have already been done previously. So I just double click there and go to that file. So here program file and a folder icon is given. So click on that folder icon. Suddenly it will ask you from where you want to choose your hex file. So I know that at the desktop, there was a folder whose name was Square Wave. Yes. So this is the folder. Just double click on there. So automatically it will show you that hex file. So just click on that hex file, double click on that hex file. Sorry, double click on that hex file. So now that hex file will be uploaded in this IC when you click OK. So I click the OK. Now that programming hex file is inside this IC. Now I want to check that whether it will work properly or not. Whether it will work properly or not. So I just see that one. Now which pin you choose to generate the square wave, because I choose P0.3 pin. So add the 0.3 pin. Where is the P0.3 pin? This is P0.1, P0.2, P0.0, P0.1, P0.2, and this pin is P0.3 pin. Okay. So I know that it will generate the square wave. To see that square wave, I have to choose at least one oscilloscope so that I can see that square wave. So choose the oscilloscope. So here at the left hand side, there is an icon of virtual instrument. You will see virtual instrument modes. So just click on that virtual instrument. So at the topmost side, oscilloscope is written. Okay, click on that. And then again, click on the your window of Proteus. Now click any channel ABCD with that pin. Okay. Now you are able to see the square view. Okay. Now you will be able to see that square wave. Now see that wait. Okay, now see the channel number A is directly connected with P0.3. Now we will see. So to see the result, click on the run. So I at the bottommost left hand side, run pin is there. So when I click on run, when I click on this run button, you will see now you are able to see that square wave is generated. You can change the size of that with the help of time per division button and volt per division button, the width and height. So now see at the channel number first, automatically a square wave will be in front of you. This one is for amplitude and this one is for time period. So a perfect square wave is now generated, which is in front of you, and that is a part of a square wave. That is a part of a square wave. Okay. So we are able to see this square wave because the program which we have already been done is in the correct format of with proper delay, because no delay was there. No delay was there. See the toggling of at pin number 0.3. If you are able to see that toggling is continuous. Blue, red, blue, red, blue, red. Red means 1 and blue means 0. So continuous 1010. That's why we are able to see this square wave, which is generated in on P0.3 pin. So this is the very first program of generating a square wave on P0.3. Now similar to that, if we done another program, but not only related with a single pin of microcontroller, with the total port of microcontroller. So how to do that thing? Now we will see the second programming. Now I stop this window and show you the same MS Paint file. Now see very carefully. Yes. So this was the first program. Okay. Now I am showing you the second kind of program. The second kind of program. Let's suppose it is also a simple program of toggling the particular port. Toggling means continuous 1 and 0. But how can we do that work? Now see very carefully. This was the first program, and we run this on software also. Now see the second one. Let's suppose my object is write a program to toggle the port, any port. Write a program to toggle means 1010, switch on, switch off, switch on, switch off. This is the meaning of toggling. Okay, but we don't want to toggle only a particular pin, because a particular pin will be toggle as a square wave, 1010, that is a square wave. But I want, instead of toggling or instead of generating a square wave on a particular pin, I just want to toggle the whole port. So how can I do? See this one. Write a program to toggle all the pins of port. Let's suppose P1 is the port of which I want to toggle. Okay. So because I know that a port consists 8 pins. Port 1 consists P1.7, P1.6, P1.5, P1.4, P1.3, P1.2, P1.1, P1.0. There are 8 pins. Okay, 1.72. Now what I want? I just want to create toggling there. Toggling means continuous 1 and 0, 1 and 0. So see very carefully the concept. How it will be toggled? A particular port. How it will be toggled? Toggling means the same, generating of a square wave. Okay, that is also known as toggling. 1010, 1010 is the toggling meaning. But here we are not talking about a particular pin toggling. We are talking about the whole port toggling. So how can we achieve the whole port toggling? So that is not a typical concept. It means we want that the total port will be in the format of 1 and 0. So one time all the pins are 1. And one time all the pins are 0. Now what is the meaning of 1 and 0? And in between these two values there is some delay. In between all the values are 1 and all the values are 0, in between these two values there should be some delay. So one time all the values are 1 1 1 1 1 1 1, then some delay will be there. Then all the values are 0 0 0 0 0 0 0, and there is some delay. So continuously you are able to see 1, then some time wasting, then 0, then 1, then 0, then 1, then 0. So your eyes can easily see that toggling. It means there should be some delay, but it is not mentioned that what delay toggling you want. So you can use any register, put any value in that, decrement that value till it will be zero, and then again jump to main program. The same kind of concept. So how we can make that program? So see, when all bits are 1111, it means what is the meaning? 1111 means 15, that is F. Again 1111, it means F. So it is in hexadecimal FFH. And when all ports are 000, it means all the values are 00H. Okay. So now remember one thing, that whenever we write down any instruction in 8051 microcontroller, the opcode and operand, two things are there. The operand cannot directly be in the format of English letter like words. It must start with a numeric digit. What I want to say, first of all, I just take a value in accumulator register. So that is move A, comma. Sorry, I just write down in caps also. Move A, comma. Now, what value you first want? That all the pins of port 1 will be 111. Okay. So the first value is, instead of writing down FFH directly, I have to write down with a numeric digit. Otherwise, it will show you error. So move A, comma hash 0 FFH means accumulator is equal to 1111. Okay. Now I want this value to be shifted into port P1. So move P1, comma A. It means the accumulator value will be uploaded into the port P1. Then I want some delay. So I write down A call and then delay. Okay. Then I want that all the value uploaded will be 00. So I just write down move A, comma hash 00H. Hash 00H. Okay. Now I want to move this value into port P1. So I write down move P1, comma A. Okay. Then again want to call the delay. So A call delay. And what is the delay? The delay is same. The delay is same. I write down the name of the delay as delay. As let any register I have, move R1, comma hash 255 value I just upload. Then decrement each time the value of R1 by 1, and till the time it will not be equal to 0, it will jump to the VVV location, then rate, and at last the program will be end. So this is the complete program of toggling all the pins of port P1. Instead of writing down move P1 A comma 0 FFH and move A comma 00H, you can directly move to the port P1 also. So move P1 comma hash 0 FFH also correct, and move P1 comma hash 00H is also correct. But because we know that accumulator is generally used in all kind of program, whenever we want to do the programming of 8-bit programming of microprocessor or microcontroller, that's why I use the accumulator here. So now we have to generate the hex file, then load into the IC via Proteus software, and then we'll run the program. So within 2 minutes, I will complete this one. Just see that Keel software now. Just see that Keel software. Now you are able to see the desktop. Now first of all go to the Keel software. Okay, now I choose the before using the Keel software, you should create a folder on the desktop. So I choose that same folder, square wave folder, and give the file name different from the previous name. The previous file name was practical. Now I will give another name of toggle. Okay, so I first of all click on the Keel software. When you click on that Keel software, it will show you the window of Keel software like this one. Okay. So it will show you a window. Okay. Now go to the project, then new, and then go to micro version project. When you click on micro version project, you will see where you want to do all the things. So go to the desktop. I use the same folder, square view, which I created. So square view. Now give the another name of file. The name of the file is now toggle, T-O-G-G-L, okay, toggle, then enter. Then Atmel Corporation IC is chosen, and which IC? 8080C51 or 8089C51. So here 8089C51 we find, so click on OK. Then no, okay, then click on new file, create a new file. Then now type the program. So now I am going to type the program. So what was the program? Now I am typing the same program, move accumulator, new a comma hash 0ffh, then move e1 comma e, then move equal delay, then move a comma hash 00h, then move even comma a, then again a call delay. Okay. Then what is the delay location? The delay location is r1 comma hash any value at 255, and location name is bbb, and decrement and jump node 0, r1 comma bbb. Okay, then create, and then end. Okay. Once again I am going to check. First, the port P1 will be 1111111 because we upload the value in accumulator as 0ffh and go send that value into P1. Then some delay is called. Then after some time, accumulator is 00. Then that will be load into P1. Then again delay will be count. Now one mistake is there. We have to go repeat this step now. So as jump to RRR, and which one is the RRR location? RRR location is this one. Okay. So there is a mistake in that program, which I, okay, I am showing you. So you will not be confused. Here in that MS Paint file, the one step error is, now you are able to see this MS Paint file. Okay, the one step error is we forget to write down here after this delay here at this location. I'm talking about at this point, you have to also write out one more thing as jump to RRR, as jump to any, again jump to any location. So the name of the location is, let's suppose, RRR. Okay, and where it is? It is the first state, RRR. Okay, so we do this. After doing this, once again, I'm showing you the Keel software. Okay, so you just type the program here. This is the complete program. Now save as. Now go to file and then save as. Okay, when save as folder will be open, go to the same desktop. Go to the desktop, then go to the square wave folder, which where you write down all the things. Now which one is your program? The program name is not practical now. It is toggle now. So toggle.asm is the name. Then okay, then go to target, then right click on the group source. There is a name which is in front of you, that is add file to group source. When you click on that add file to group source, go to the square wave folder, then ASM source file. So there are two files, practical, which we did in the previous case, and now it is toggle.asm. So go to toggle.asm, then add. Automatically the file will be added here. Okay, this one. Now go to flash, the same things, the same steps. Go to flash, then configure flash tool, then go to output, then click on create hex file, and then okay. And then when you will click on that bold target, if there will be no error, it will show you zero error, zero warning. This one. Okay, now your hex file is created. So close that window. Now to run the program on Proteus software, click open the Proteus software. So go to the desktop again, then go to desktop, then go on Proteus software, this is seven professional. Double click on that, go to the bin, then go to ISI. So where is ISIS? ISIS is this one. So double click on that ISIS folder. Yes, sorry for the disturbance. Now your Proteus software will be open. Okay, so I am now showing you the Proteus software. After click on ISIS, you will see a window of this one. So this is your Proteus software window. Now go to P, click on microprocessor IC, then go to 80C51, and then click on OK. Then click on desktop. Okay. If you want to improve the size, then click like this one. Okay. Now the size is increased. Okay. Now where is the file? See very fastly, double click on that, go to the folder, and where is the folder? On desktop, square wave folder was there, so click on that square wave folder. What was the name of the file? The name of the file was toggle. Just click on toggle, then okay. Now the file is in this. Now see very carefully the port 1. Toggle means continuously 1010. When you will run this, you will see continuously 10101010. Blue, red, blue, red, blue, red, blue, red, continuous on this pin. Amit, if you understand this toggling program also, write down in message box, yes, so I understand. Type in message box, yes, so I understand. Okay, so this is the, yes, so this is the toggling program. So this is your second program. So I hope you understand about how to run the programs on microcontroller, right? So I, Rakesh Jain from Gyanmar University, wants to thank you for watching the video. Kindly like and subscribe the video. And if you have any query, feel free to ask me any query. Thank you very much.